that. Can you see the limb? You think you can do that one out? It's up to you on that one. Okay, I'll cut it slow. All right. Here we go. glad to help you pull it up. I help too. Ready? There we go. It'll swing. Keep going. Got it. Thank
Hey, what's up, guys? You're on Meet Tree Boy for Life. I just wanted to show y'all something. Okay, I'm in this little limb, this big old gum tree. I'll give you an idea of what I'm doing here. I took down a bunch of stuff over the house already. My head cam died, so I don't know if I'll piece this with another video or just post it by itself. But you can kind of see a little bit of these 2 liters right here. That limb has some stuff over the house that's higher. You took most of the stuff off of the bucket truck. That small bucket truck, but I still got a lot at the top to take out. But here's the situation. My rigging line is tied up here. You can't really see the line there, but it's up a little higher than my climbing line there, and it's out. But I wanted to show you something. Sometimes when you're falling limbs, now these ain't real big limbs, but if you got a cluster of limbs, the best way to fall these is you do them consecutively. But what you have to do, it's just a little trick of the trade, just to keep the limb off the top of you. That way you won't have to worry about unclipping yourself or something like that. But basically, you go up under the limb on this side. Now you got to be tied up pretty high. Now you can't be expecting to do this with like a lateral tie-in point with your rigging set up. You have to be pretty high to do this. But you go underneath or around the bottom limb, and then you find a spot. I'm doing this with one hand because my stupid head can't. And then you clip in or you tie off or whatever y'all do. And basically, what this does is this will keep this limb off of you. And I'm gonna show you how to do it, how I do this, and I'm gonna show you what the dealio is. So I got it tied off, and I'm doing it right here. So I clip, that's tied in. Okay, pull the slack out. Make sure there's plenty of way, you know, room for the slack to go, because it's gonna drop a little bit behind it. So you gotta make sure when you tie off, you gotta calculate the amount that you got tied to where you go down. Because you see down here, I got a shed, a bush, a fence, and a house. And I think the man is inside of there too, so you gotta be careful. So, but just check this out. Okay. Take it. When it rains, it pours. I said, when it rains, it pours. Pull string came off. I'm just gonna throw this down. Watch yourself, okay? You see it? You'll throw that in the bag for me. I'm gonna bust my lip. Well, I'm gonna do this with my handsaw. Actually, it sucks. Stupid thing. Got me cutting like an old guy. I can like this and see me now. The early 1900s, the hands, I ain't gonna even wedge it, cause it's got a mean lean out this way, but you'll see, it's cut through pretty good. Just remember just to hold this one, okay? Okay, roll it up a little higher there. Y'all probably think I'm crazy when I be doing these videos sometimes. I know, I'm probably thinking the same thing too. But just watch how this limb goes, and you'll see it. It'll start going soon. You can hear it almost. There it goes. Come on, baby. Come on. Come to papa. And see, the thing is, you want this limb off of you. You want this limb right on top of your head, on top of your climbing line. See, I mean, your rigging line. See, I really don't have nowhere else to tie in. So, here we go. Here we go. Here. Look at that. You see how I did it? Not only was I able to give it off, keep it off everything, but it ain't on me. The line's out there. It's getting rolled down straight. Looks like I'm gonna have to hand saw the rest of these, but so I ain't gonna be able to videotape them. But I'm gonna do the same thing with this next one right here. I'm gonna do the exact same thing, just to go under me, and it will clear all that stuff. And again, you have to be pretty high when you got your tie-in point. You can't just think you're gonna do this and you got a lateral climbing line. I'm way up there. I'm probably about tied in. I think I'm probably about almost 60 foot. Don't seem like that, but I'm close to 60 foot up there. But that's where I'm at here. So, just wanna say what's up. Sorry about that. Had a malfunction with the chainsaw. I bust my lip, punched myself in the mouth. I pulled that string out. Crazy. Peace out, y'all. Make you go for life.
Thank you. Okay. Hey Vic, help him hold this one. Help him with this one. It's coming from a little higher, okay? It's coming from a little higher, so it's gonna kind of pull you a little bit. He'll help. I said, oh, I'm sorry. No, I'm cutting little pieces. Hey, at any time, I'm going to let y'all use y'all judgment if y'all see something I'm cutting. As long as you see what I'm cutting, you can about determine what you need to do. You know, some stuff, if it's standing straight up, you remember it's coming down real hard. So it might be better to put in the device, but some of this little small hinging stuff, you know, you probably won't need it. But if more than likely though, if I think it will, I'll let you know.
Down.
not. I'm going this way still. No, no. I don't want to hit this brick. We fine. I don't care about the pavement. Yeah, we should be good. We should be good. Yeah, it's fine right here. Send me up that little Husqvarna too. I'll get my lanyard down there to you. All right, put this one in the device for sure. Put one wrap on it. All we're doing is trying to let this thing bottom out. Probably gonna roll around that way, and then you let it slide. When it start going, just go ahead and let it down till it hit the ground, and then. Hold on.